When we saw the extraction zone getting on deck, we were all of us saying, wow, this is a good one. Excellent. Look at that. Tons of trash from the ocean.
Huge pile of ghost nets. A lot of it's still boxed up already. A lot of rigids as well. And we found a lot of the pieces that we deployed as a test. I think we're running pretty high efficiency. Yeah, happy, really happy.
I see success.
Flying through it.
Plastic bottles for oil, detergent, hand wash, everything.
Every little thing is gonna be all right. It was difficult, of course, to sort all this trash, but we had a plan first to go with the big things. So we have these three groups, like big ghost nets, hard plastics, and all the small things. Then we basically take these and put them in big bags. We take the bag and we weigh the bag, we tag it, and we seal it. We follow a standard to certify that this plastic is actually genuine ocean plastic from the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. Basically, we are seeing this extraction as a success, and it is a success. But it's important also to realize that not everything is going well all the time, you know. We have unexpected events, things to repair as well on the system.
Good morning, everybody. We'll just kick off then. So yesterday we started the deployment of the system. Everything went very well and according to plan, I'd say. Unfortunately, we've also discovered something wrong at the interface between the wing section and the retention zone, and we'll go out in the boat this morning to see if that's something that can be repaired in water. If it can't be repaired, it unfortunately means that we have to recover the entire system back to the trailer and do the repairs there.
I don't know if you can see behind me, but the weather is picking up, wind is picking up.
So we replaced two lashings between the flip over net and the waterline rope. Yeah, two guys held it and Ali just went through and...
Okay.
We have a magician from Iceland who has saved the day. So we thought that there was going to have to be a full system recovery because there's a problem up at the top end. But fortunately Ali over there was able to go in and repair it from the FRC.
Keep coming up.
The weather's coming up tomorrow, so we would have lost all the weekend, but now we're able to get this in the water today and we'll get towing.
Now we are on the straight road, so I'm very happy about that. But I'm also working with very nice people and good working people. Everybody is giving hand, and we are working like a team.
Saturday and the weather was up on Thursday, so we had a day off. It'd been pretty choppy. We had a look at what was going on and we could see there was a little bit of damage taken. There was a fender that came loose, so we've just removed that just now. We were having a look at the system to see if there's any tears or any damage that's been done.
If you want to improve your design and if you want to improve your efficiency, it's vital to monitor how quickly things wear, and from that you know what points to address in future designs.
Jenny has been in water for a couple of days already. We are moving forward, catching plastic for this huge catch that should have a big impact. We are going to understand more about the limits of the system, the limits Jenny is capable of.
We've done all this testing. We've done testing going in this direction, going in that direction. This speed, that speed, different coordination between the two vessels, and now the focus is just to get as much plastic as we possibly can and prove that this is the way to clear the ocean.